France Africa Summit is currently underway in Nice, and joining us on the line from Paris is Sylvain Touati, research fellow at Sub-Saharan Africa program at the French Institute of International Relations. Sylvain, thank you so much for your time today. Let's start off with the fact that Africa has been under the spotlight for some time, and of course this Africa France Summit is also making quite a bit of headway. We are starting to see quite a bit of news coming through, but the big focus predominantly is to try and strengthen business relations between France and Africa.
Hello.
Very good afternoon to you, Sylvain.
Yeah, yes. Good afternoon. Yes, exactly. Economy was supposed to be the major issue in the France-Africa Summit, but world governance and reform of the securities, UN Security Councils was gaining most attention. Mm. The presence of President Jacob Zuma, Goodluck Jonathan, Abdelaziz Bouteflika, and other ones were there for this specific issue of world governance. It seems France succeeded to convince African leaders that they need to minimize their wishes concerning the reform of the UN Security Councils. Mm. There was an African Union consensus reached in 2005 at Ezouweni, claiming to permanent seats for Africa with right of veto. But France succeeded in the summit to persuade African leaders to go for an intermediate way, allowing one or two African members at the UN Security Council for a period from 5 to 10 years, but without the right of to veto the council. This issue may make economy less a discussed issue, but it was still very important.
Well, Sylvain, also, you know, looking at what the French president has said, President Sarkozy, talking about Africa being the future, looking at why it's such a big focus right now, we know that French-African relations have been very strong for some time now, but there seems to be a bit more of a focus at this stage, and we know that there is a lot of growth prospects for the African continent.
Yes, exactly. In France, in the last decade, France realized that there were possibilities to make a larger business in Africa. They've seen Chinese, Indian, emerging countries making a lot of investment and succeeding. And that's really impressed France and French company, and they decide to review their way of doing business and in Africa. And there is a will to that French state and business sector is going to work more closely to make better proposition to Africa, making better deal, providing larger loans, larger investments, and in the idea that it could be successful for African people and African states, but also for French companies. And that maybe that's a new mentality that we've seen in the summit. Africa is an opportunity for French business, and they need to find a way to enjoy it more.
Well, it's also said that Africa is quite an important area and, of course, place in terms of the business sector globally, because most companies, most businesses out there are looking for yield, they are looking for growth, they are looking for an upcoming consumer, and Africa seems to be offering that to many countries out there. You mentioned China. China is very interested in African resources in the agricultural sector as well. What are French companies looking for right now? Where would they like to see their money invested?
French is present in the mining and petrol sector, but only with one or two companies, Total and Areva. So that's not going to change in the coming year, and I don't think that you're going to have French offer on iron or cobalt or other mining issues. But there are other sectors where France is quite important and successful. I think telecoms and banks is a sector where French companies are already present in Africa, and they need to they're going to improve and enlarge that presence. You also have the sector that urbanization is going to make it very big. It's recycling water. Veolia is one of the big companies. Suez are big companies, French companies, and they're going to really enjoy the fact that urbanization is growing in most of African countries, and that's going to offer them a large market.
Looking at the significance, given that many countries are now celebrating 50 years of independence, how's that been taken up? And we know that Africa has come a long way since independence for most of the countries on the continent.
This is very important part in Africa. It's very important. However, a major part of African population is born after independence. in the first country we have celebrated the event this year, the comments from the population were more about the future than the past. One of the main comments that was coming back that there is no more excuse for their leader to not find a way to access better governance and economic development. African population wants the change. And they're not really into the relationship with former colonial power. These ones have changed in the recent years. Emerging countries, as we said, China, India, and Brazil, are more interested in Africa, and they propose new partnerships. So former colonial power need also to adapt their partnerships. They need to propose new offers, and that's definitely a better challenge, better game for African diplomacy and African economies to get which partners can offer the best deal and which one we can choose. And that's important because before there were like a one-to-one relationship between, let's say Mali and France, and Malian couldn't get other deal. But now they have other opportunity, and that's going to really change in the future.
Sylvain, thank you so much for your time today. That was Sylvain Toati from the French Institute of International Relations.